Hi friends, welcome to EduTap. So we are back again with a discussion of 5 MCQs having detailed explanation. Now this is a regular series which has been offered by EduTap, where we come up with 5 different MCQs each day having detailed explanations. Now these MCQs are relevant for our NABARD Grade A and B 2018 examination. They also have relevance for other agriculture related examinations like IBPS AFO, FCI, IBPS AFO Scale 2 and RRB 2018 examinations. So friends, there's a change which has been announced by NABARD regarding the postponement of the prelims examination. Earlier it was to be held on 12th May 2018 and the fresh dates haven't been announced yet. So we are expecting that there's not going to be much delay, at the most maybe a week or a two. So you don't need to worry about it. Kindly continue your preparation as you're doing it now. So to help you out, EduTap has come out with this series where we shall cover a number of concepts through different MCQs. To know more about our courses, kindly visit our website www.edutap.co.in. Currently, we are running a flat 30% off on our NABARD course and kindly use the coupon code NABARD30. And for those who are our RBI Grade B subscribers, so kindly send us a mail regarding your subscription of RBI Grade B so that we can give you 50% discount. So friends, as part of the earlier video or the previous video that we had discussed, there was an elaborate discussion that was done on the primary nutrients nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium, and we had discussed 3 secondary nutrients, that is calcium, magnesium and sulfur. Now both these primary nutrients and secondary nutrients come under macronutrients, right? And now in today's video, we shall be discussing 4 micronutrients: boron, chlorine, copper and iron. Okay, so these are the 4 things that we are going to discuss. These are micronutrients because they are required in smaller quantities. Though they are required in smaller quantities, they are actually very, very important. So first let us begin with boron. So as we had discussed, what we shall be doing is we shall first discuss the functions of the various micronutrients, right? And after we are done with the functions, we shall pick each one and see what are the visual symptoms in case of the deficiency of that particular micronutrient. Okay, and then we shall solve 5 MCQs related to these four micronutrients that we are going to discuss today. Okay, so boron. It is necessary for pollen germination. This is very important. Kindly memorize this. There's one important key fact that you need to know, that boron is actually the only non-metal element among the micronutrients. Okay? So there are 8 micronutrients. As I told you, nickel being the latest to be added, right? So among those 8, boron is the only non-metal element. So this is something that you need to remember. Now, boron is concerned with water reactions in the cell. Okay, they may act as a regulator of potassium ratio and it keeps calcium in soluble form. Now, there's one important fact, that the taste in cauliflower is due to the presence of boron. Now friends, there can be n number of functions, but we are going to discuss only those that are important and you need to memorize these. Now we come to chlorine. The first thing, it is absorbed in the Cl- form. Okay, this is essential for photosynthesis and it acts as an activator of enzymes which are involved in splitting water. So those enzymes that actually split water require activation, and for that activation, chlorine plays an important role. Okay, it also functions in osmoregulation of plants. Now, what is this osmoregulation? It is maintaining the fluid balance inside the cells. Don't go deep into it, just have a rough idea about it. Okay, and those plants that are growing on saline soils, chlorine is very much required for osmoregulation. Now, what are saline soils? Those soils that have higher quantities of salts in them. Okay? Now comes copper. Copper is a constituent of a number of important enzymes. So this much is enough for you to know. Just keep in mind few of the names like cytochrome oxidase, ascorbic acid oxidase. Just try and remember these. It is important for reproductive growth, aids in root metabolism. This is important. Okay? And essential for photosynthesis and respiration. Friends, you need to revise them again and again. Only then it will actually help you in retention. Now we have come to iron. It's an essential component of many enzymes. Okay? And it is essential for the formation of chlorophyll. This point is very important. Never forget it. It acts as an oxygen carrier. Okay, so we are done with the functions of each of the micronutrients that we were discussing. Now you can see the nutrient deficiency symptoms of plants. This we had discussed as part of a previous video as well, so I'm not going to be repeating it. You can pause this video, have a look at the various nutrient deficiency symptoms. Now, this is a very important chart that I had mentioned before as well. You can see that this chart shows the appearance of the deficiency symptoms. And you need to know this. It is quite important for you to memorize this. So we are dealing with boron, chlorine, copper, and iron, right? So if you can see here, boron comes under category where terminal buds get affected. Okay, so yesterday we had seen what is a terminal or an apical bud. So if this is a plant, at the tip of it, the new leaves that are being formed in, okay, that is the apical bud or the terminal bud. So in case of boron deficiency, the symptom would first appear in this terminal bud. Okay, then if you see copper, the symptoms would be seen in the new leaves. And there's an occurrence of yellow veins. You would be able to understand this better because in the coming sections, we shall see the symptoms elaborately. Okay. Then comes iron. Okay. Again, the symptoms are seen in the new leaves. Okay. Let us move forward. So these are the terms that we had discussed yesterday as well. Chlorosis, mottled, and necrosis. Chlorosis, yellowing. Mottled is marking with colored spots due to the deficiency, and necrosis is occurrence of patches of dead tissues, right? Now here again, we had seen the parts of the leaf. Just quickly, these are the veins. This is a midrib, and the space between the veins is intervenal space. So whenever you refer to a word which says intervenal chlorosis, always understand that we are talking to the space which is between two veins. Okay, this portion. Now let us come to the deficiency and the excess part. So first let us begin with boron. Okay, so here majorly what is happening? Yellowing is happening. Okay, what is it? It is chlorosis. Okay, now first let us read through it. So it starts from base of terminal bud leaf and extends to tip. Okay, so you can see the picture here. You can see that first thing it is targeting the apical buds or the leaves. Okay, and it is starting from the base. The base gets yellow first and then it extends to tip. Okay, and here you can see that it forms whip like structure like this. Okay, and becomes brownish and blackish in color. The picture also shows that, you know, there is occurrence of browning here. So as you see, starting from the base, moving to the tip, and finally becoming brown. Okay, then you can see, very important, there are certain disorders that have been mentioned here, like internal necrosis in Ionla and mango, hen and chicken disorder in grape, heart rot in sugar beet, and in this part there are other disorders as well. Kindly pause the video and make sure that you memorize all these disorders. There can be a question like, due to the boron deficiency, which of the following disorders occurs, right? So memorize the names. Then we come to chlorine. Now, in many of the books, there is a mention that the deficiency or the yellowing of the leaves actually occurs in the older part, older leaves. Okay. So what you do is you just remember that the wilting takes place in the younger leaves. Okay. There is a bit of yellowing which is taking place in the older leaves, and the younger leaves become wilt. Now, what do we mean by wilt? Wilting is a situation where the leaves actually lose their rigidity. Okay, you can see here the diagram. You can see a perfectly normal flower. And because of wilting, you can see that the flower gets shrinked. It loses its rigidity. Even in this picture, you can see here, right? All the leaves are wilted. Okay, so this is a thing. Here in the picture, you can see that there's an abnormal yellowing which is observed. Okay, now for wheat, a plant disease will infect the plant if there is a chlorine deficiency. So directly there will not be any symptom, but indirectly, because of the deficiency of chlorine, wheat would get easily affected by a disease. Kindly remember this as well. Now there's one important point that you need to know, that if chlorine is in excess, then there is leaf scorching. What is scorching? Excess burning of leaf takes place. Okay, in yesterday's video also, kindly recall, there was a nutrient in relation to which we were talking about scorching and burning. Now, I'm not going to mention the name of it. You must be aware by now if you had gone through the video perfectly. So, kindly recollect. Next, moving on to copper. Okay. Here in copper, kindly have a look at the picture which is given below. The leaves, including the veins, become yellow and tending towards whiteness. Okay, basically, if you see, the margin becomes yellow. Basically, there is burning of margin that is taking place. So whenever copper, you tend to just remember this. This is very important, that the margins show yellowing, in a way burning. Okay, and there is a very important disease, that is dire bark and little leaf disease, which is caused in citrus. So it is very important for you to remember. Plus there is other disorder, which is gummosis and xanthomania. Pardon me if the pronunciation is not correct. So these disorders also you need to remember. Now we have come to iron. Okay, so you can see the picture here, and in the picture it's very evident this is a normal leaf and this is a leaf which has iron deficiency. You can see here that the veins are green, okay, but the spacing between the vein, which we call intervenal position or the space, is yellow. So we have already studied that this is a condition which is intervenal chlorosis. Okay, so because of iron deficiency, this is something which is observed, and it causes leaf bleaching in sugarcane and ivory white of paddy. Very important. So kindly memorize this. Now you can see the picture here. Yesterday also we had discussed. So let us just pick the nutrients that we are discussing as part of a discussion today. So boron. We had seen that it affects the terminal bud. You can see here, right? So yes, you can relate. Yesterday we were seeing about calcium, right? Calcium also targets terminal bud. So you can, again, you know, a short time for recollection. So kindly pause this video, analyze this picture, and try to solve it by yourself. Okay? Then let us just see the other things that we were discussing. Yes, okay. Copper here. We have iron. Okay, so iron, just now we have seen that there is a yellowing taking place in the intervenal position. The picture is not quite clear here in the case of iron and copper. So I guess you need to just revise for boron and the other nutrients. So there is some misconception when you see for iron and copper. Yeah, and for copper, as we had discussed, that the younger leaves show wilting, right? And what is wilting? We had seen that the rigidity of the leaf is lost. So you can see that the leaf is not erect. So this is something related to wilting. So let us just quickly discuss five questions based on the content that we had discussed today. So we are not going to go into the explanation because the discussion is in itself very sufficient. So which of the following nutrient is the only non-metal micronutrient? Remember the first point that we had discussed regarding boron. So the answer to this question is boron. Now the second question, the deficiency of which of the following nutrients causes hen and chicken disorder in grapes? Quite a different disorder. So the answer to this question is boron. Now these questions you need to memorize, no other go. The third question, the deficiency of which of the following nutrients causes ivory white of paddy disease? Very important. Answer is iron. Fourth question, E. Grace established the essentiality of which of the following elements in the year 1844? The answer is iron. So this is a table which you need to memorize. And the left you can see the elements and the right the name of the scientist, those who have established the essentiality of these elements basically. Kindly memorize them. We have come to the fifth question now. Which of the following nutrient is necessary for pollen germination? Yes, answer is boron. Here you can have a look at the answers for the questions that we have discussed. So friends, with this we have come to the end of this video today. So we have discussed four important micronutrients, boron, copper, chlorine and iron, right? So there are four more to go. In the next video of ours, we shall be coming out with explanation for those four. So I hope you found this video useful. If yes, kindly like, subscribe and share. And thank you for the great response for this particular series. It really gives us the motivation to work harder each day for you people. And to access the PDF of this particular video, kindly go to the EduTap's Telegram channel. The link for the channel is placed on your screens. Till then, friends, thank you and happy learning.